the story of a son reconnecting with his estranged father, and one critic called it a powerful universal story, and it's the author's first novel. Here to tell us more about it, the author himself, Brian Leung, who I just found out grew up in Lakeside.
Indeed, it's good to be home. Yeah,
yeah,
that's right. Yeah.
Nice to see you.
Glad to be here. Thanks.
Tell us a little bit about your movie, Lost Men, about your book, Lost Men.
Well, let's hope it's a movie, right?
Okay, well, someday. Flip of the tongue that hopefully will work.
Well, it's a story of a father and son who have been estranged for 25 years, and the father pops up after all that time and apologizes for having abandoned the son, and says, as a way of apology, I want to take you to China. And so they go on this, the son is angry, but he agrees to do it, and they go on this trip to see whether or not they have any kind of relationship left. This
trip
to China.
That's hard to do after 25 years.
They have some things to work out, that's for sure.
Right.
Yeah, yeah. But it's, you know, it's kind of like a story, I think, about families, like kind of the families we choose and the families that we're assigned, and maybe the families that we choose to push away. Yeah.
Don't tell me how it ends. Don't tell me. Obviously, if they, you know,
the butler did it.
If they, exactly. Right. If they come back together, but there's some interesting things, kind of a mystery about a note from the mom. Is that right? A letter.
There's a really what the father doesn't tell the son is that there's a question of paternity. The father's Chinese. The son is half Chinese, and it's possible that the son might not even be their son. So all this hurt that's gone on for 25 years may not even mean anything.
Wow. Right?
Yeah.
Wow.
So the note keeps popping up during the novel. You know, sometimes some people have said frustratingly so, because it's just about to be opened and then they decide not to. They pull back. Wow. And I won't tell you what happens at the end.
No, and you want them to keep turning the pages.
Yeah.
Now, a little bit of this is based on some travels that you did. Tell us about that.
In 1997, my father, who's Chinese, and my sister, also is full Chinese, and I took a trip to China. It was during the time of the Hong Kong turnover, actually, and so it was a really exciting time to be there. And we did about a 2.5-week tour through China, and I kept a really, really intense journal, and which is partly how the book came about. And we got to go back to my father's village where he grew up for part of the time, and the village from which they escaped in 1949 during the communist takeover.
Really?
Yeah, and that was really intense.
That must have been pretty powerful to be there.
Especially to see my father in that situation, because my grandmother actually got caught there until 1980. And so there's a lot of kind of a real reservoir of hurt for him, because knowing that his grandmother was stuck in this place with no electricity,
sure,
no running water, that kind of place, you know, it's really agricultural, like hand farming, and
uh-huh,
knowing that his grandmother was, or I'm sorry, that my grandmother was doing all that labor there, right, and living in a little shack. And
hard to see.
Yeah, it was difficult. For me, it was kind of more, it wasn't a reality, but for him, I mean, all those pictures were playing in his head. Yeah.
Is he okay? Basing a little bit, you know, you base a little bit of a character or the relationship between you guys, and you take it into a book and put it on pages for the world to see.
I've been making it a point where in any reading I've done where there are relatives,
mm-hmm,
to say, I want everyone to know I have a great relationship with my father, you know, which is totally true.
Right.
Because I don't want anyone to think that, you know, that's the part I got to imagine, right, is like, what if this character doesn't have a relationship with his father. I'm lucky in that way, right?
Oh, that's good. That's,
yeah,
good. So he's okay. You're like, you're just writing about the trip, son. You're not writing about us. You're not putting any private stuff in here.
That's right.
Right?
Yeah, huh.
And so you live now in
Louisville, Kentucky.
You teach
that's
there.
1 year. I've been there. Just celebrated 1 year there. But I'm, you know, I'm from Lakeside. I lived here until I was 20. Then I moved up to Los Angeles. And now I'm having mint juleps and watching, going out to Churchill Downs, right?
Fun, very
yeah,
fun. All right, let's put some information up about your reading. You have a reading today, is that right?
That's correct, at 1 o'clock at Carmel Mountain Road
Borders. There.
Right,
excellent.
1 o'clock.
And you're going to read some of it, just give people a little tease?
Yeah, like two chapters from the, two
and
short
it's out,
chapters.
Right? It's out.
It's out, came out June 12th. It's doing really well.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Well, congrats.
All right, thank you.
You have to go on another trip, so you can base another novel on the trip somewhere else.
France this time. How about France?
Very nice. Right. I like it. Or Italy. I like it.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you.
All right,
nice to see you. Nice to meet you. There is a special classic car show going on today in Chula.